come join us here at the CabaRay.
That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.
From the Ray Stevens Studios in the heart of Nashville's Music Row in Music City, USA, it's Ray Stevens, CabaRay Nashville.
My heart keeps going back to Nashville. That's the only place for me. My love is waiting there in Nashville. Nashville, Tennessee.
With Ray's guests, Wilson Fairchild, Marissa, and the A-Team. Uh-oh! It's him again, Margaret. Ray Stevens!
Back in 1974, we re-recorded an old standard jazz ballad in a different way. And it won a Grammy that year for the best arrangement of the year. Look at me. I'm as helpless as a kitten up a tree. Oh, I'm walking on a cloud. Can't understand, Lord. I'm Misty holding your hand. Walk my way, and 1,000 violins begin to play. Or it might be the sound of your hello. That music I hear, Lord. I missed it the moment you leave. You can't say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? So I'm following you. Should have wandered through this wonderland alone. Never know my right foot from the left, my hat from the glove. A mistake, too much in love. Oh, tell me what time. You can say that you're leading me on, but it's just what I want you to do. Don't you notice how hopelessly I'm lost? That's why I'm following you. Through this wonderland alone, never know my right foot from the left. I had from the glove. I'm missing too much in love. Welcome back to CabaRay Nashville. We've been waiting for you so we could get started. So, let's get started.
Yeah.
Now here at CabaRay, we got a couple of cousins that are highly acclaimed songwriters. They've been writing songs since their teenage years, squeezing in their love of songwriting between football games, baseball games, and chasing girls. Their songs have been recorded by country, bluegrass, and gospel artists, and they record their own songs too. As a matter of fact, they wrote a tribute song that they performed for their dads, Harold and Don Reed, when the Statler Brothers were inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame. Please welcome Will and Langdon Reed, who call themselves Wilson Fairchild.
All right. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Now, how'd you come up with the name Wilson Fairchild?
Wilson Fairchild. It's a good question.
How did we come up with that name?
Well, a few years back when we were playing music, we changed our name in the business when we entered the Music Witness Protection Program. We wanted to record music and not have anybody know who we were.
Right, exactly. We wanted to keep it on the down low, so that's when we went to Wilson Fairchild. Yeah. And actually, that's our middle names. My middle name is Wilson, and his middle name is Fairchild. Uh-huh. And we decided that if the music thing didn't work out, we'd open up a law firm. Wilson and Fairchild.
And associates.
And associates. Yeah, Esquire.
Good. I like it.
Yeah, doesn't that sound good?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, it's going to work.
I think, why not? I mean, you know. You've been writing and playing together your whole lives. Mm-hmm. And what was it like, though, growing up the sons of Harold and Don, of the Statler Brothers? I mean, you know, that's kind of a, some would consider that a burden.
Depends on what day it is.
Yeah.
That's right. Yeah, musically, it always has its challenges. But honestly, Langdon and I can both say that since the time we were kids, we were always inspired by what our dads did.
Now, you guys toured with George Jones for a while. Now, what was that like?
We did. We were George Jones' opening act for about 3.5 years. And what an education and what an experience. Mm-hmm. You know, this was it's kind of an interesting story of how it came about, of where we our relationship with George.
Oh, exactly. And a lot of the glamorous stories from the music business, this is one of them. Because we were at home a few years ago, and George Jones was going to do a show right across the mountain from where we lived. And I called Langdon, and I said, man, we have got to get on that show. And he said, well, sure. And I said, I'm going to call somebody. So I called the promoter that was putting on the show, and I said, hey, you know, we are Wilson Fairchild. We want to open up that show for George Jones. Do you have an opening act? And he said, no. I said, well, can we do it? He said, sure, but we're not going to pay you. And we said, fine. Absolutely. We'll be there for free. No problem. So we went. We got to open up a show. We got to meet some people, and it was a great experience. So then after that show, we found out he was going to be in Pennsylvania the next weekend, you know, 5 hours away from us in Virginia. So I pick up the phone and I called Pennsylvania and I said, hey, we're on tour with George Jones. What time should we be there? And the guy said, well, that's fine, but I'm not going to pay you. So we went anyway, again, for free.
Sure.
And so that time we did get to meet Mr. Jones and Nancy and everybody in the band and begged our way onto some shows and said, hey, you know, George Jones shows reminded us so much of our dads, you know, and traditional country music. So we said, hey, anytime we can open up a show for y'all, let us know. And we had a nice relationship with them for about 3 or 4 years.
We never got paid, but at least we got free catering.
Well, you know, as good as you guys are, I think George Jones is one of the few acts that could follow you guys.
Oh, what so, a nice thing to say.
No,
thank you.
Listen, I've heard you. And tell us about coming to write the Statler Brothers song.
The Statler Brothers song is a tribute song that Will and I wrote to the Statler Brothers. And again, when they were inducted into the they were inducted into the Gospel Music Hall of Fame. Then the following year, they were inducted into the Country Music Hall of Fame. And we felt that was a perfect time for us to finally write our own Statler Brothers song. And that's what we did. It's a tribute song to them of their 40-plus years in the business, of all the award shows and the comedy and the live concerts and the TV specials and everything they contributed to country music. We tried to take those 40 years and put it in about 3.5 minutes.
Well, sing it for us, okay?
We would love to.
Yeah, let's do that song.
All right.
call America's poets, who started out as a gospel quartet. You entertain on and off of the record, and your records will never forget. You sold out shows to millions, sang your part in four matching suits, and accepting your awards, and always thank the Lord in tuxedos and patent leather boots. So carry me back to Virginia, and let us hear how great thou art again. And if you ever hear the stage a calling, we'll even love you better than we did then. We love Shirley Jean Morrell and Elizabeth, the bed of roses makes me Atlanta blue. And thank you, world, for giving us the Statlers, 'cause we'll go to our grave loving you. Songs about making memories and childhood heroes years ago. And then you met all of your heroes and had them on your television show. But you never forgot where you came from or got lost in the fortune and fame. Flowers on the wall to the last curtain call, country music will never be the same. No, it won't. So carry me back to Virginia, and let us hear how great thou art again. And if you ever hear the stage a calling, we'll even love you better than we did then. We love Susan when she tried, and Elizabeth, a bed of roses makes me Atlanta blue. And thank you, world, for giving us the Statlers, 'cause we'll go to our grave loving you. America salutes the Statler Brothers, 'cause we'll go to our grave loving you.
Oh, man, you got an album that pays tribute to your dad's songs, mm-hmm. covering songs that they co-wrote over their 40-year career. Tell us about that.
The name of the CD is called Songs Our Dads Wrote. It's pretty clever, isn't it?
Over a 40-year career.
It took us, about 2 months to come up with that title.
Right.
But we honed in on that. And you're right, it is. It's songs that our dads, again, Harold and Don Reed, two of the primary songwriting members of the Statler Brothers, and we went through their catalog and chose 9 songs on this particular CD that they co-wrote together. Some of them are hits. Some of them are like some deep album cuts over the years, and others are just some great story songs that we've always felt close to.
And well, we learned how to sing and play guitar listening to all those records.
Absolutely.
That was the inspiration for the project, yes.
Yeah.
Well, why don't you do one or two of those songs for us?
Oh, we'd love to.
We can do it.
Wilson Fairchild, ladies and gentlemen.
Well, thank you so much. And we would love to do one of those songs that our dads wrote that we grew up listening to. Here's one of our favorites.
If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry. If she gets lonely, don't know why.
so am I. Sing your song, son.
If she's changed, I'll take the blame. And if somehow she's not the same, if there's a distant look in her eye and she's lost the will to try, if she seems bitter of other days, seems to have lost her Baptist ways, if the truth comes harder than a lie, if she's guilty, so am I. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry, she gets lonely, don't know why. If she's guilty, so am I. If she comes and talks to you and asks you what she should do, well, give her hope and give her help and ask her not to blame herself. She was right, more than wrong. We weren't weak, we just weren't strong. So just hold her hand and let her cry. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry, if she gets lonely, don't know why. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's guilty, so am I. If she's forgotten how to cry, she gets lonely, don't know why. If she's guilty, so am I. So am I. So am I. So am I. So am I.
Wilson Fairchild, ladies and gentlemen. That was great, even though you overproduced the ending. Hi, this is Ray Stevens with some great news. My CabaRay gift shop has gone digital. You no longer have to drive to Tennessee to see all the stuff we have for you to enjoy and buy. Take your time and take a nice long look around at all the ball caps, t-shirts, monkeys and squirrels. We have keychains, cups, mouse pads, and books, CDs, DVDs, and so much more. Everything we have in the gift shop is now available to you here online. So fill up that shopping cart. A big part of the Nashville music scene is made up of people coming here to try to get in the music business as recording artists. And it's not easy. There are numerous talented people who never make it after years of trying. But I think our next guest has a really good shot. Please make welcome Marissa.
Believe, but I can't take my good. brush on it, just to watch you walk away again. Even though tonight I want you back, oh, I can't take my goodbye back. It hurts like hell, and it's hell that I wanna hold you in my arms just one more time, but I won't put myself through the pain, 'cause I know you don't mean it, no matter what you say. Watch you walk away again. Even though tonight I want you back, oh, I can't take my goodbye
Marissa.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Marissa. You know, we got the NFL, the NBA, the NHL, and the MLB. Here's a song about the MLB. Football is a macho sport, and it's great when leaves are blowing. And basketball's just right inside when all outside is snowing. But when spring is in the meadow and the robins start to sing, that old familiar feeling can only mean one thing. The star-spangled banner and the smell of fresh popcorn and that corny organ music makes you glad that you were born. Come on home to baseball.
Come on home.
Baseball. With a hot dog and a cold drink, you'll be feeling like a kid. Come on home to baseball. Come back home to baseball. To the bosom of America, you'll be so glad you did. And the umpire yells, play ball, and you're sitting beside your girl. Your troubles are all out of here, and all's right with the world. And there's nothing like the crack of the bat on the home run ball you hear, or the rush you feel when the entire grandstand stands as one to cheer. Or the silence when it's 3-2 in the ninth, and it's 2 away. Bases are loaded, the score's all tied, and you hear somebody pray. Oh, come on home to baseball.
Come on home
to baseball. Get a hot dog and a cold drink, you'll be feeling like a kid.
Come on home to baseball. Come back home to baseball.
to the bosom of America. You'll be so glad you did. Come on home to baseball. Come on home to baseball. Get a hot dog and a cold drink. You'll be feeling like a kid.
Come on
home to baseball. Come back home to baseball. In the bosom of America, you'll be so glad you live. A legendary songwriter here in Nashville, Bobby Braddock, wrote a great song called God is Great, Beer's Good, and People Are Crazy. People really are crazy, you know. I mean, this lady called an airline, said she wanted to take her dog on her next trip and asked what she needed to do. And the airline agent said she had to provide an airline-approved carry-on kennel. And the dog had to be able to stand up, lay down, and turn around in it. She said, good grief, I'll never be able to teach him all that the next week. We've really enjoyed being with you. It's always fun when you drive by, so make sure you see us next time here at CabaRay Nashville. Ma'am, would you dance with me?
Good night now. When you come to Nashville, don't you forget to come see us at the CabaRay. This is Bill Cody. We'll see you next time.
Come join us here at the CabaRay. That's the Ray Stevens CabaRay and Showroom right here in West Nashville. We're easy to find at the Charlotte Avenue exit off I-40 West. It's the place in Nashville for a special entertainment and dining experience. There's great food, all your favorite wines and mixed drinks, a fun piano bar where you can sing along and dance. And there's the Ray Stevens Show, where I'll sing all my biggest hits with Nashville's best musicians and singers. So whether it's a special date night, entertaining friends and family, or you're just coming out to sing along in the piano bar, whatever your reason, the CabaRay is a fun place to enjoy a full night of entertainment. And the parking is free. So come see me, Ray Stevens, at the CabaRay. Call 615-327-4630 or go to raystevenscabaret.com. Make your plans now.